Sankarea the Abridged Series is a non-profit fan-made parody. Sankarea is property of Kodansha, Shonen Manga, Studio Deen, Funimation, and Mitsuru Hattori. Please support the official release. My name is Rea Sanka, and I live with my two parents. This is my mother, Aria. She may seem a little cold and distant, but I'm sure she loves me. I think that it may be that she's busy all the time. Whenever I ask her what she's doing, she tells me that she's spending some quality time with her American friend, Jack Daniels. And this is my father, Danichiro. He shows his affection more openly.
You know, darling, we don't have to stay here for breakfast. We could go up to our room and have some fun.
And miss spending time with my precious daughter? I think not.
Well, he shows more affection towards me, anyways. My father is the principal of Sanka Academy, a private all-girls school that I will be attending next year. I'm happy that I'll be able to go there, but I'm afraid that my father will go overboard. He can be quite overprotective at times. If he isn't keeping a close eye on me, those who work under him are.
It isn't fun on this end either. I hate my job.
Hey, Rea!
Oh, hello.
Did your dad have any problem letting you sleep over at my place this weekend?
No. He said that it was all right after he heard that you didn't have a brother.
Why would he care about that?
I don't know. All he said was that I wouldn't have to worry about losing something I can't get back.
Whatever. As long as you can make it.
This is why I think Father should be less protective. I can tell which people are only using me, and the people who are truly my friends.
Speaking of your dad, could he possibly have some connections to my dad's company? Because if it isn't too much of a big deal, could he pull some strings to get my dad a promotion? Yeah, that's Rea's mansion.
Wow, we were thinking of getting a mansion just like that once my husband successfully gets the promotion! He's been working it! It must be so nice living in luxury.
Well, it is, but I don't think that is what is important.
Huh?
A mansion is nice and all, but I think that it's family that brings the most amount of happiness into a person's life, not objects.
But I would be happy if we got to drive something like a Lamborghini!
Do you really have to keep talking about my dad's money? I wouldn't say we're that rich.
But you could buy anything you wanted, right?
I guess.
If only you were a boy.
I don't know. If I was a boy, then I'd be some kind of lustful pig.
Who told you boys were like that?
My dad.
Well, he doesn't know what he's talking about. Boys are great, especially when they have money and abs and a dark tan, a Ferrari, a cute butt, a mansion, and are really big.
Heart?
No. Wallet.
Could it be true? Could boys actually be harmless? If they are, then maybe Dad wouldn't have to worry about me so much. Maybe he wouldn't be so overprotective. Dad, can we talk?
Of course. You can talk to me about anything.
Well, it's about boys.
Oh. We're not going to talk about that.
But I thought you said I could talk to you about anything.
Yes, I did. But boys are nothing. Therefore, we are not going to talk about them.
Why not? Maybe they're not as bad as you say they are.
Can you tell me a single teenage boy you've met who wasn't bad?
Technically, no.
If you haven't met any, then they must not exist.
That's not fair. I haven't met any boys my age.
Of course not. That is because I'm doing my job. You see, teenage boys only want one thing. Actually, it's two things, but the second is breakfast after the first thing. I'm doing this to protect you, my dear Rhea.
If the second thing is making breakfast, then how bad could it be to give them the first thing? Father, where are you going?
To get a pond rake. There's some scum I have to get rid of.
I thought that you usually had the maids take care of that. Moving? Is she really moving today?
Yeah, I heard it from Hinata, who heard it from Ai, who heard it from Kyo, who heard it from Hanako, who happened to hear someone say it out loud in the cafeteria yesterday.
And I heard it from her when she announced it to the class.
That's the bell. We better get going.
See you later, Rhea.
I already told you! He just went up to me and said that I went off the deep end and that I was responsible for dirtying his pure pond.
What does that mean?
I don't know!
I heard you were moving. Why didn't you tell me?
You normally don't say those kind of things to the person who ruined your life.
Huh?
My father was suddenly transferred to a lower-paying job in the poor part of town. We're probably going to be demoted to upper middle class now. It's downhill from here. I'm going to have to go to school with poor people. I don't want to be associated with them.
It can't be that bad.
You would say that. I'm sure you felt just terrible resting comfortably in the upper class with your dad and all his influence.
It can't be. My father would never do anything like this. He can be a bit controlling, but he wouldn't push my friends away. He wouldn't do something like this. He wouldn't. Would he? Why did you do it?
Do what, sweetheart?
Transfer my friend's dad.
I pulled some special favors to make sure he wouldn't be on this side of town.
But why?
To protect you, my Rhea. His daughter's presence was corrupting you. Rhea, you're a pure girl. Boys would only command you to do terrible things that would defile you. Now, take off your clothes. It's time for another photo.
Lately, I couldn't help but think that things aren't supposed to be this way. My parents, my friends, my life. It should all be different. I shouldn't be treated special because I was born into a rich family. I should be treated special because I'm me. Maybe I can wait and hope things get better.
It is